What we've got here now is this batter which we've made. We've allowed it to cool down. I'm going to put it back into the pan again now. Alright, now it's in the pan and we're ready. Now don't add it all too quickly because if you do it and scramble it when it separates and it'll come flying out the pan which is what you don't want. So just add a little bit of egg at a time. Right. It's quite difficult to add a little bit of egg in, as you can see. It all drops in. If you look in the pan, you can see it's sort of separated at the moment. You keep stirring it and stirring it until it starts to come together. At the end of adding the egg, and what you'll find is the mixture is a little bit thinner than when we started. What we're looking for is... folded the bag back and I'm just keeping my hand over to pop it in. But if you find that a struggle, your other option is to put it into a grater. Just make sure your bag's wide open so you don't get any of the mix on the outside of the bag. Because if you do, this is the end result on the choux pastry. As you can see, they're evenly brown and they go, if you move on to the other tray, exactly the same. It's what you're looking for, it's exactly the same size. You may need to reject some because they do have this shape. For this exercise now, we've got the choux buns ready. I've got a piping bag, we've got them. Opening them up, we're going to put them in rows. So I know which is the top and which is the bottom. Finish them off. I've got the piping bag and a nozzle. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to use some of the chocolate just to do a little, what we call a rope. And move my hands, as you can see. And then the final part is to pop the lids on. But what we'll do is we'll pop them on an angle so you can actually see the chocolate is up. Finally, just a little tap of icing sugar. Yep. Next one we're going to do some little choux buns. We're going to do them slightly differently. But again, you need to open them up, put your filling in the bottom. We do a swirl this time. And these are just little swirls to go in the bottom of them themselves. Just to make it pretty, we're going to put the lids back on, upside down. And in this case, we can finish the lids off with a little bit more of the chocolate ganache. These, we just put a little strawberry on the top, just a quarter, and what that does gives you a nice little...